Okay, students, good afternoon, all of you. Welcome back to another session of live online webinar classes for the intermediate students. I am Nagamani from TSRJC, Vaira. In previous sessions, we already discussed about the phylum Echinodermata. What are the echinoderms? Means echinoderms have a spiny skin. What is that, students? Skin have a spines. For which purpose? For the protection, for the escaping from the predators. Okay, so we already discussed about the different type of general characteristics. What are the students? It have a spiny skin, means next to different type of the organisms are presented in the echinoderms, like sea urchins, sea biscuits, sand dollars, and osteras. Next, little stars, like that. So many organism shows the so many diversity between them. And next, what are the specialized system present in only echinoderms? What is the students? Water vascular system. In which purpose they used that? Means here, using for the locomotion, means they are moved from one place to another place by the using of the water vascular system. And another one for the food collection also. And next, excretion also. So that's why different type of the systems of the echinoderm organisms are does not develop, because only single system replace the total body system. Okay, student. And then next, we already enter into the classification of the echinoderm. How many classes there? Means five classes. Majorly five classes are presented in echinoderms. What are there? In five classes, we already discussed about the Osteroidea. Okay, next to Ophiuroidea and Crinoidea. Crinoidean organisms have a stalk-like structure, means body have a stalk and anterior region have a one funnel-like structure, and it have a so many arms, means tentacle-like structures, nothing but the umbilical grooves, which are collect the food, and it have a cilia, and it collects the food from the water. Okay, next, they are the filter feeders, and so many characters we already discussed. Next, then going to the Osteroidea. What will happen in Osteroidea? Means they are the sea stars. And so many water vascular system is presented here. Umbilical grooves are closed, like that characters. Okay, we already discussed it. In Ophiuroidea, they are the brittle stars. Okay, arms are in a long motion, and they shows the movement from one place to another place, and like some segments like structures are shown in their body. Okay, the type of different characters we already discussed about the echinoderms and the classification of the Echinodermata. Okay, next we will enter into the class Echinoidea. What is that Echinoidea? We already some much portion of this Echinoidea also completed. So we again recall that. What are the organisms present in this class? Means sea urchins, sea biscuits, and sand dollars. What are the students? Sea urchins, sea biscuits, all of you look into these pictures, how they are diverse from one and each other. Okay, how are they different from look liking also, and the systems also, and they all are having water vascular system. In that also, we already observe the different type of the variations between the organisms. Okay, what is that, like sand dollars and sea biscuits, like that. So much food items which are we like. Here, class Echinoidea. What are the general characteristics? Here includes Echinoidea includes echinoderms, popularly called sea urchins, hot urchins, cake urchins, sand dollars. Okay, like that. So many food items which are we already like. Okay, so we simply remember that organisms by the these food items. Okay, they are 950 species of the known echinoderms. Okay, in the Echinoidea, we observe the 950 species of the echinoids we will observe. Okay, what are the general characteristics? Means here body is a globular, means around and oval shaped and discoidal shape, heart shaped, like that. Different types of the shapes are we observe. Okay, now next. And oral and aboral surfaces, we already know about these oral and aboral surfaces. Arms and umbilical grooves are absent here. All of you look into these pictures. Okay, I will show here. For example, you take a ostrias, means starfish. These are the arms we already discussed. Okay, students. These are the arms. Okay, this is the one organism of echinodermata, not echinoidea, echinodermata. Okay, next, another one, you take a bristle worms, like, okay, like this manner. Okay, worms. Why? Here, what are these? These are the arms. But in the case of echinoidea, means the arms and umbilical grooves are the opposite. Means, for example, it is a one of the sea dollar. Sea dollar. Sand dollar. One organism. It does not have any arms. Okay, like this. All of you look into these three pictures. There is difference is present or not? They are totally different in structure. This is the different class, and this one is from the different class, and this one from the different class. This is the ostrias, means have a five arms. It is a brittle star, have a long arms, and it is a sand dollar related to the echinoid. Means here we did not observe any arms. And umbilical groove means what, students? We already discussed in that water vascular system. Means here in the water vascular system, it is a madreporite, very important one. Okay, it is a madreporite. Okay, these are the radial arms. In the radial arms, we observe the umbilical grooves on the tube feet. Okay, students, these are presented in that class. But in the case of echinoidea, we does not observe the any arms and any umbilical grooves. That all are the absent. Okay, here next, what about of body? We will discuss about the body. Okay, students, arms and umbilical grooves are absent, and body is in the different shapes, like oval shape, heart shape, globular shape, round shape, like that. Okay, here, next. Okay, students, here, the whole body is enclosed in a box-like shell. Okay, body is enclosed in a one box-like shell known as corona. Okay, we already discussed in the previous class. It is not a coronavirus pronunciation, like that. Also called as a test. What is the students? Test formed of the calcareous plates. What is that? Formed of the calcareous, means calcareous plate. Here, next, worn on the test and covering the whole body is an armature of movable spines. Here, once again, we will discuss about this. Here, for example, one box like test is presented. In this, we will observe the body of this echinoidea organism. And here, what is the next one? Here, we will observe the movable spines on the body. Movable spines on the body. Okay, students, like the box like structure is presented. This is nothing but the test. In the test, we will observe the body of the echinoidean organism and have a movable spines. Okay, and mouth is surrounded by a next layered membrane called peristome and anus by a periprom. Means here, for example, it is a organism and here mouth is presented by a peristome. Once again, you recall the earthworm. We already discussed about that. What is that peristome and prostomium like that? In the mouth, we observe the two or three, not a mentioned number, but here peristome is presented. The membrane-like structure is presented. That nothing but the peristome and anus by a periprom. Here, anus by a periproct and mouth by a, what is that students? Peristome. Here we will observe. Next, mouth is owned with a characteristic chewing apparatus called aristatine lantern. What is that? This is the important one, very important for the 2 marks and special characteristics of the echinoidea. What is that students? Aristatine lantern. We will discuss in some deep way. Okay, here, all of you look into this picture. For example, I again take a one echinoidea organism and body is with the spines, movable spines. It is a oval shaped echinoidea. Okay. Mouth is presented and backside anus hole is presented. Here, mouth is having a chewing apparatus called aristatine lantern. Why we are called means here Aristotle is the one famous philosopher. We already know about him. Okay, about him. What is the specialty of Aristotle? He already write the so many books on the natural sciences. Okay, and also he observed the echinoidean organism like urchin, sea urchin, and he observed the mouth is look like a chewing operator, five-armed operator that is called Aristotle lantern. Means here in the ventral view, we will observe the mouth have a five-armed jaw-like structure present on the mouth. In the ventral view, we observe like that it is in the differentiated mode. It is in the differentiated mode. Means it is a one jaw, it is second jaw, it is three jaw, it is fourth jaw, it is five. Like, but internally they are connected together, but the outside of the mouth we will observe like this in manner. Okay, five-jawed chewing operator is called Aristotle lantern. First time, Aristotle is a famous philosopher, also a natural scientist. He worked on the echinoidal sea urchin organism and he recognized the mouth of the sea urchin contain a five-jawed chewing operator is nothing but the Aristotle lantern. In the ventral view, outside of view, we will observe the Aristotle lantern in a five-armed means, for example, it is a one jaw and it is a second one, it is a third one, like this manner, like five jaws are presented. In the ventral view, we observe like they are in a differentiated mode, but internally they are interconnected. Okay, but ventrally we are observing like this. So Aristotle will discover the sea urchin mouth have a five-armed chewing operators, that nothing but the Aristotle lantern. Okay, student, this is a very, very important example is sea urchin. 2 marks question, important. Okay, Aristotle lantern is the important one. Okay, students, and then next, arranged in between the spines and extending between the peristome and a periprop are five double rows of a cupid. Okay, this point also nothing but the Aristotle lantern. We already discussed in a deep way. Okay, five arms are, five jaws are look like in a separated manner from the ventral view, but in the internally they are connected. Okay, Aristotle is discovered in this first time, so nothing but the Aristotle lantern. Okay, sexes are separate. Development is indirect with characteristic larva called Echinopluteus. What is that? Echinopluteus larva. Okay, development, sexes are separate means what? The male organism is separate, female organism is separate. But development is indirect with larval form. Which larval form? Echinopluteus. Example, Echinus, Echinocardium, like the different type of Zalmic is like different type of the organism. Okay, students, this is all about the Echinoidea. And another class, the nothing but the Holothuria. What is that, students? Holothuria, the sea cucumbers. What is that? What are the examples? Sea cucumbers means here body is like a cucumber structure. Okay. Next, what are the general characters of the Holothuria? We will discuss it. Holothuria is a group of leathery and almost cylindrical echinoderms, commonly called sea cucumbers. Always almost cylindrical. Cylindrical body means how they are presented. The body is in the cylindrical manner. Okay, like this. Cylindrical echinoderms, commonly called, what are the students? Sea cucumber. The major diagnostic feature of the Holothuria is the following. Okay, here the general characteristic is there. Body is a long and cylindrical, almost all organisms are in bilaterally symmetrical and body is divided into two halves. And body wall is laterally and dermomuscular means here. The dermo means what, students? The skin. The skin and muscle are combined and form a functions. The skin and muscle are in the combined mode. That type of the skin is called dermomuscular. What is that, students? Dermomuscular. Skin and muscles are in combined mode. Next, mouth and anus are at opposite means. Means here anterior region have a mouth and posterior one have a, what is that? Anus. Okay. Opposite end mouth is encircled by a crown of the repeat 2 feet known as buccal fodea. Here, mouth is encircled by the crown-like structure. Here we will observe this crown-like structure and have a, what is the, students? Tube feeds. Okay, known as buccal podia, which are modified as oral tentacles. What is the, students? They are modified into oral tentacles, which are used for the sensation. What is the function of tentacles? They are used for sensory. Okay, body is in the cylindrical mode and have a dermomuscular skin. Means, dermis means skin and muscle are combined form a functions and bilaterally symmetrical and anal pore is separate and oral mouth pore is separate. Okay, and the here in the mouth side, we observe the 2 feet in the buccal podia and modified into oral tentacles. What is that? Oral tentacles. Next, dermal. Next, radial arms, spines and pedicillaria are absent. Here, radial arms means what? In the Austria's case, all of you recall that we observe these radial canals. Okay, like this. But in the case of the Holothuria, the radial arms, spines and pedicillaria all are absent. What is that? Absent. Dermal ossicles are microscopic and vestigial and loosely scattered. They are the microscopic, means the small structures are presented. The dermal ossicles have small structures. Vestigial means what? They did not have any function in the body. Okay, and loosely scattered. And next, umbilical grooves are absent and madreporate is internal. This is also important one. The madreporate is external or internal mode. In the Holothuria case, the madreporate is the inside the body. Okay, the madreporate is internal. In most cases, madreporate cannot have no external openings or hydropores. Here, In the previous class, we discussed about this. Here, madreporoid structure is like this, and it have some pore-like structures, nothing but the sieve plate. Okay, sieve plates is presented in this madreporoid. In the some cases of these holothuries does not have any external openings of the madreporoids. Okay, student, and this elementary canal is long and coiled with a definite cloaca. Okay, elementary canal have a long, okay, it has a long structure and coiled. Coiled means what? Okay, like this manner, coiled, foldings are presented. Okay, here the connected to the cloaca are the so-called respiratory trees or cloaca glials. Okay, they are also connected with the respiratory trees, which are used for the respiration. The well-developed respiratory structures means respiratory trees or cloacal glials, which are used for the which one, students? For the respiration. And then next, connected to the cloaca are so-called respiratory trees or cloacal gills. Yes, circulatory system is more advanced than that of other echinoderms. In the other echinoderm, the circulatory system is a poor open type. Means the water vascular system shows different functions of this. But in the case of the holothurians, they have an advanced circulatory system based on their other echinoderm, and it is function to transport of oxygen and perhaps the nutrients, also used for the transporting of the oxygen. Okay, students, well developed circulatory system we will observe in which case? In the holothuria. Okay. Okay, students, the next development is indirect, means here also have a larval stage with characteristic larva called auricularia. What is that, students? Another one, another new larva. What is that? Auricularia. What are the example? Holothuria, mesothuria, cucumeria, like that. Different type of the organisms we will observe in the holothurian case. Okay, the next. This is all about the classification of the echinodermata, 5 classes and their differences, similarities, how they are having larval forms, like that. Okay, next we will enter into the another interesting one, that nothing but the phylum Hemichordata. Hemi means what? Half. What is that, student? Hemi means what? Semi. Hemi means half. Hemichordates means in the case of previous classes we will discuss about the non-chordates, means the invertebrates. They did not have a vertebral cord. But hemichordate means what? The characteristics of the chordates in this hemichordata some of the characteristics are presented in the hemichordates. Okay, they are presented some more characters of the chordates, like that we will discuss in a deep. Okay, hemichordates are a worm like marine animals. What is the, students? Worm like structure. Where we will observe this worm like structure? In the case of annelids, it have a worm like structure. Okay, in the case of hemichordata also, it body have a worm like structure, and they are present located in the oceans, marine. Okay, and organ system level of organization is observed in the hemichordates. Organ system level means what, students? Here, digestive system, circulation, excretion, different type of systems perform the different functions for the coordination of the body. Okay, next, bilaterally symmetrical. Okay, body is, shows the bilateral symmetry. Okay, means body is divided into two halves. And here we will observe they are the triploblastic. Triploblastic means what? The three germ layers are which are used for the developing of the body organs, like ectoderm and endoderm and mesoderm are the present. Triploblastic animals. And coelomates means true coelom is presented. What is that, students? True coelom is presented. True coelom means what? The antennocoelomates. And next, another one. Body is a cylindrical mold and body is divided into three major parts. What are their proboscis? Here, all of you look into this picture. It is a one of the organism of hemichordata, nothing but the balanoglasses. What is that balanoglasses? It is a proboscis and it is a collar which is presented in a necrease, and apart from that, most of the part is trunk. Proboscis, collar and trunk. It will be divided into three parts. What is that? Proboscis, collar and trunk. Okay, students. Here, what are the affinities of the hemichordate? What are the relation between the other organisms here with annelids? We already discussed about this worm-like and segmented body is the similarity between the annelids and a hemichordate. Annelids and echinoderms are related to invertebrates. Okay, so it is not a invertebrate and it is not a vertebrate. Semi means hemichordata. Okay, next, with echinoderms, blastopore is presented, enterocoelous, true coelom, and enterocoelous coelom, and ciliated bands in the respective larva. Ciliated bands, which is used for the feeding and also locomotion. And with chordates, what are the relation between the chordates and hemichordates? Here, presence of pharyngeal gill slits. What is that, students? Pharyngeal gill slits, nerve cord, and so-called notochord. Here, the general characteristic in the animal diversity, in the upcoming chapter, we discussed about that. What is that means? Here, generally, the chordate characters are, four chordate characters are presented. What are that? Nerve cord, dorsoventral nerve cord, notochord, pharyngeal gill slits, and postanal tail. Okay, they are the general characters of the chordates. Here, that are pharyngeal gill slits and nerve cord and so-called notochord is present. They are the similarities and affinities between the invertebrates and the vertebrates. Okay, students. And next, here, some of the circulation is open tank. What is the student? Circulation is in a open tank, means your blood flows in the outside of the vessel. Means here no definite heart and no definite vessels are present. Respiration through which gill slits. Here, all of you look into this picture. They are the gill slits. This is the number one character of the chordate. Okay, major important character of the chordates, gill slits, pharyngeal gill slits. Means pharyngeal gill slits means they're located at the pharynx region. Pharyngeal gill slits and respiration by the gills, because they are the marine. So they are the respirator by gills, and excretory organ is proboscis gland. What is the students? Proboscis gland. Here, proboscis gland is presented. This is the excretory gland in the hemichordata. Where students? Hemichordata. And then next, what about of the respiration? Reproduction means sexes are separate. What is the students? Sexes are means male hemichordata is separate, female hemichordate organism is separate. Means male balanoglasses is separated, male female balanoglasses is separate. Fertilization is external and development is indirect. What is the students? Indirect means what? There is a larval form. There is a larval form, but fertilization is external, means outside of the body they will fit in. And then the larva is nothing but the tornarial larva. What is the students? Tornarial larva. This is the picture of the tornarial larva. It has a highly modified cilia. Highly modified cilia, which is used for the collection of the food. Collection of the food. Okay, tornaria larva. This is the larval form of the hemichordate. Okay, all of you listen. And next, we will enter into the classification of the hemichordata. What is the students? Classification of the hemichordata. How many classes we will observe means here? Two classes. What are they? Enteroneusta and Pterobranchia. Enteroneusta and Pterobranchia. Okay, here. Then, what are the general characters of Enteroneusta? Enteroneusta means enteron means gut. Neustrans means breathe. Gut-breathed organisms are enter into the enteroneusta. Okay, also called as a acorn worms. What is the students? Acorn worms, and they are the free, solitary, and burrowing. Means they are did not depend on any other organisms. They are freely movable and burrowing means they dig the burrows and lives in that burrows in the seas, oceans. And shows the Tornaria larva. What is the students? Tornaria larva. What are the general characteristics? Again repeated. Endereo neusta, acorn worms, also called acorn worms. Free, solitary, and burrowing nature, and Tornaria larva is presented. Then next, Pterobranchia, and second class is the Pterobranchia. They are the free, but in the Pterobranchial case, they are a colonial zooids, means they are living in a groups, colonies. Okay, like that, colonial zooid, and construct rigid tubes, and they construct the rigid tubes and have a ciliated tentacles. Means here, students, for example, it is a one organism of Pterobranchia. Okay, like this manner, and they have a very strong tubes and have a cilia, ciliated tentacles on their body. Ciliated tentacles means cilia hair like structures are presented in the these tentacles. Okay, and also presented in the inner side, we will observe the U-shaped gut. What is the students? U-shaped gut we will observe. And also one is the important character. What is the character of the chordate? Pharyngeal gill slits. Pharyngeal gill slits are the presented. Okay, these are the all the characters of the Pterobranchia. What is that? Colonial means they live in a groups and construct a very strong tubes and have a ciliated tentacles and have a U-shaped gut and pharyngeal gill slits. Okay, students, this is the characteristics of the Pterobranchia. How many classes we will observe? Entero neusta and Pterobranchia in the chordate. Okay, next, these are the examples of the hemichordata. What is the students? Examples of hemichordata. What are that? This is the one of the organism of hemichordata, means balanoglosses, and it is a sacoglosses. Balanoglosses and a sacoglosses. Okay, these two like a worm-like structures, means it is a proboscis and it is a collar, and remaining one is a trunk. Here also it is a proboscis and it is a trunk, and it is means collar and it is a trunk ridge. Okay, how they are very look like a variations between this structure is similar, but organisms are different, but total systems also different. What are the balanoglosses and sacoglosses are the examples of the hemichordates. Okay, what we learn, students, from the animal diversity one, different type of the invertebrate shows the different type of the variations between their locomotion, symmetry, organization, coelom, and the systems, organ systems, like digestion is different, circulation is different, excretion is different, reproduction is different. Okay, larval forms are the different, development is different. So many diversity is presented between the our animal diversity one. Okay, this is the last one which is included in the invertebrates. What is that? Hemichordata, means they did not show a total complete characteristics of the chordates. So that's why we are separate this phyla like hemichordates. Okay, this is the assignment of your class. What is that? What are the silent features of the Osteroidea? What is the students? What are the silent features of the Osteroidea? What are the general characters? Okay, how they are having a different type of characters, and what are the silent features of the Holothuria? Okay, silent features, what are the how they are differ from another classes, how they are developed from the another classes of Echinodermata, and give the brief account of hemichordates. Okay, it is a simple one, simple body structures and a simple classification, not a long phylum. So you will write about the all classes, classification and general characteristics of the hemichordates. What are the examples like? And next one, what is Aristotle lantern? Give examples. Okay, we already discussed about Aristotle. First time discovered the sea urchins, five-jawed masticatory organ presented in the mouth of the echinus. That nothing but the Aristotle lantern. Give example means sea urchin. Okay, this is all about the assignment of your class. Okay. Next, not only these questions, all questions, two marks questions are very important, but we don't have a much time for that. So you all prepare for that. Okay, students. And also once recall the animal diversity one, like Porifera to Echinodermata and also Hemichordate. Why we are called as a Porifera, why we are called as a Cnidaria, what is the important of Tenophora and what is the important of Platyhelminthes, why we, the type of organisms are included in the that type of phylum, that related phylum. Okay, what is the Nematyhelminthes and what are Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata. This is a so many basics is presented. This is a important topic for your knowledge, zoology knowledge in the first year. This is the basic one. When the basic is the strong, in the higher classes you will be becoming to gems. Okay, the next two, finally I say thanks to our secretary sir and also DS sir, and also thank you very much for the students for leaving of this class and